Very good morning, children. Once again, I welcome you all for the biology class. Today, we are going to see lesson number 7, part 3 in this video session. Children, before starting our video session, I would like everyone to join for a word of prayer. We'll have a short prayer before starting our video session. Our most gracious, loving Father in heaven, we thank you for this good day you have added in our life. Lord, we thank you for this blessed morning. Lord, we thank you for our parents. We thank you for our teachers who are all supporting us from the back. Lord, today we are going to see some diseases and their symptoms. Lord, protect us from these types of diseases. Give us good health and strength so that we can stay healthy and lead a happy life. We ask these few mercies in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Children, I welcome you all for the biology session, video session. In this, today we are going to see lesson number 7, health and hygiene, part 3. Okay. In this, first we will dealt with what are communicable diseases and how they are all spreading. Next, part 2, we learned about some transmission of diseases. Transmission of diseases, we had two parts. In that first part, we learned through direct contact, and second one we learned through food and water. The second part we learned through air and through other organism. This is the second part in the transmission of diseases. And the last topic we was discussing was how to avoid infection. Now we are going to start a new session, that is by communicable diseases, non-communicable diseases. First, we were seeing communicable diseases, and this one we are going to see about non-communicable diseases. Today, we'll see about 2 to 3 infections. Okay, our main agenda of this video will be with 1, 2, and 3. We'll try to complete our video session up to this, and if time permits, we'll go for another 2 diseases also. If time doesn't permit, we'll stop up to rickets. Okay. Let's get started. Today, we are going to see mainly about non-communicable diseases. Here, we are going to see about non-communicable diseases. In this, non-communicable diseases, I am going to divide it into 2 parts. The first part with the, with 1 or 2 types of infections, and second part will be the remaining part of infections. Okay, children, now let's get started. As I told you in the Zoom class, I will tell you the point-wise explanation in your video session. The first thing is non-communicable diseases. The first, we'll write the topic. Non-communicable diseases. This is the first topic, of this video session. Non-communicable diseases. If you come to this non-communicable diseases, we'll see mainly 4 important points. 4 important points. What are the main cause of non-communicable diseases? First cause is improper diet. We'll see about improper diet. Okay, improper diet. Second one is we'll see about unhealthy lifestyle. Unhealthy lifestyle. Third point is old age. If you're getting old, age, what type of diseases will come? That diseases will come due to, thus diseases will come under the category of non-communicable diseases. Fourth important point is malfunctioning of organisms. Organ, not organism, malfunctioning of an organ. Malfunctioning of an organ. Particular organ will not work in other particular organ will work will not work in a proper manner, will cause some non-communicable diseases. And the last point is other reasons. Other reasons also are responsible for spreading non-communicable diseases. Okay, children, these are the 4 important points in which we are going to see the non-communicable diseases. Main cause for non-communicable diseases. First one is improper diet. Second one is unhealthy lifestyle. Third one is old age. Fourth one is malfunctioning of an organ. And fifth one is other reasons. Yes, children, shall we go deep into this? This improper diet may lead to deficiency diseases. improper diet and unhealthy lifestyle, these two things will join together to form a particular disease called deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases. For this, no microorganisms or any other organisms will not be involved. Okay, only the external factors will be involved in these two types of diseases. First one is improper diet and unhealthy lifestyle will lead to deficiency diseases. Come, let's get started with this type of diseases. This type of diseases, what is meant by deficiency diseases? Deficiency means what? Patrakurai. Okay, deficiency means patrakurai. Deficiency diseases. The main cause of this deficiency diseases means there is no or lack of certain important things. Deficiency means lack of some important minerals, vitamins, any other proteins, carbohydrates, some important factors which is present in the food. Okay, if it is missing in our food, surely we will get deficiency diseases. It is always recommended for us to take a proper diet to avoid all type of diseases. Okay, lack of some nutrients. Lack of particular things which is present in the diet. Which is present in the diet. Okay, children. Next thing we are going to see about a disease by name marasmus. How to pronounce this? Marasmus. The disease name is marasmus. The child who lack, it is mainly caused in the children. This disease will be seen mainly in the childhood period. Okay, child of younger age will be affected with this disease. Child who lack protein in their protein and carbohydrate will get this diseases. Okay, the child who is not having sufficient amount of protein and carbohydrate in the body will get this type of disease. Okay, children, the child who lack protein and carbohydrate will get this marasmus diseases. And what will be the symptoms? The symptoms, how the body will be. The body will be shrunken. Okay, the body will be shrunken and the ribs and the bones will be seen. Ribs and all bones will be seen, visible to us. Only skin will be present in the body. In their body, they will have very little or no fat. Kolupu chatti irukadu with no or little fat. Okay, the body they will have, in that body content will have no or little fat. Okay, the body will be shrunken and the ribs and all bones will be visible to us. If it is like that, it will be just like a skin covered with a bone, skin and bony. Okay, the child will look like a very old people. Very old person. Okay, children, child who lack protein and carbohydrate will get this marasmus diseases. What will happen? The body will be shrunken. Okay, the body will be fully very skinny and bony, very thin in nature. And the ribs and all the bones will be visible to us. Okay, they will have very little or no fat in their body. Okay, children, the children will look like a very old people. And it will also cause, this infection will cause also cause a very dreadful dreadful thing called bouts of diarrhea. Bouts of diarrhea. What is this bouts of diarrhea? If you just Google it, they will show you inflammation in the intestinal wall. Inflammation means what? Vaitrupun. Okay, no need to write. I'll just name it. They'll be having infection in the intestinal wall. And other important thing is they will have hair loss. They will have hair loss. This is a very important thing. The child will not have a hair. Okay, they will have bouts of diarrhea and hair loss. They won't have hair in their head. This is a very dreadful disease which is almost common in Indian children. The children who are lack of protein and carbohydrate. Protein, it is almost rich in all types of nuts. Carbohydrate, it is highly found in rice. When the parent are unable to give sufficient amount of rice to that child, sufficient amount of dal to that child, surely this type of infection will come. Okay, children, next we will move on to the next disease by name Kaskikhor. It is mainly caused by deficiency of proteins during childhood. Only deficiency of protein. Okay. Only deficiency in protein will cause this type of diseases. Deficiency of protein will lead to this type of infection. In this, what is the symptom? How the symptoms? How the child will be? The stomach and ankle region will be swollen. The stomach and ankle region. Stomach means vayiru. Ankle means where the girls used to put golusu. That ankle region become swollen. Swollen in nature. The first thing is deficiency of protein will lead to this disease. And what is the symptoms? The stomach and ankle become swollen. And the other parts of the body will remain thin and bony. Other parts of the body will remain thin and bony. Thin. They look very thin in nature. And bony means what? The bones will be visible. Okay. And for this type of infection, which organ gets damaged is liver. Liver gets damaged in this disease. Liver gets damaged in this disease. The child will suffer from frequent diarrhea. The next important point is the child will suffer from frequent diarrhea. Think about one or two times if you go to toilet, we feel very tired. Think about these children when they get frequent diarrhea, how they will be. Very soon they will lose their life. When this type of infection comes to that child, it will make the child very sick and very without having any stamina, without having any energy. They lose their energy in a very fast manner. The energy gets drained up energy in a fast manner, and it leads to death. And another thing is how the color of the hair will be discolored. They'll have a brown color, discolored hair and patchy skin. The main important thing is patchy skin. The skin will be very patchy in nature. Patcha irukum skin ellam. Okay. And both of occurs mainly in the childhood period. Okay. These type of diseases will be commonly found in children. Okay. Children with poor feeding habit. If they don't have money to get rice. Think about our lifestyle, children. We have got enough money we have got enough rice in our house, but what we are doing, we are wasting it. But there are many children who die without proper nutrition. Okay children, next we will see about, once we'll revise it, deficiency of proteins, and stomach and ankles will become swollen in nature. Other parts of the body will remain thin and bony. Which organ gets damaged is liver. The child will suffer from frequent diarrhea. Discolored hair and patchy skin will be present in the body. Okay, next infection what we are going to see is, rickets. This is also one of the dreadful diseases found in India. It is common in India. Okay. It is common in India. Many children are affected in India with this infection. Okay. Rickets. Next we are going to see about an infection or disease by name rickets. This is mainly due to deficiency of vitamin D. Deficiency of vitamin D will lead to this one. Or improper absorption of calcium. This is the important thing. When vitamin, I'll tell you one important thing. Vitamin D and calcium are good friends. When vitamin D is present in the body, automatically the calcium in our body, the calcium in the food will be get absorbed. If the vitamin D is lacking, the calcium will not be absorbed in a proper manner. So, if vitamin D is there, calcium will be present. If vitamin D is not present, calcium will not be absorbed properly from the body. Vitamin D helps in absorption. Okay, the second thing. What will happen? Improper absorption of calcium will lead to weakening of bones. Will lead to weak bones and bending. And the bones get bent. The bones will get in. If your bone is like this means if the child is suffering from rickets infection, the bone will be like this. It will be very flexible and it will bend like this. Can you imagine bending a bone? So, if there is no proper vitamin D in our body, the calcium will not be absorbed. Automatically, what will happen? The bones will be easily bended. Okay, and it won't be in a hard manner. Bones will be in very hard manner. But if the child is suffering from this rickets infection, the bones become weak and soft in nature. And what will happen? The child cannot, unable to stand properly. The child leg cannot, will not be in straight manner. It will be like this. Exactly, it will be like this. The child can't walk properly and unable to stand straight. This rickets is a very dreadful infection which is still in India. It is still prevailing in India. The last thing I want to complete it with, this is scurvy. Okay, we'll go with, time is there, we'll complete the next infection also, next diseases also. Next diseases is scurvy. Scurvy. It is deficiency of vitamin C. It is mainly caused by deficiency of vitamin C. What will happen? What is the symptoms? Swelling and bleeding of glands. Swelling and bleeding from gums. Gums means what? Not Fevikwik or Fevicol. All these are gums. When your tooth is here, okay, your tooth is here, it will be holded by a muscle like structure. In Tamil, they will see it as ear, pal ear. Okay. This one is called gums. If you are suffering from scurvy, there will be a swelling. Okay, the gums will be swelled and it will be red in color and sometimes bleeding will come. This infection is called scurvy. This infection is called curvy. It is mainly due to deficiency of vitamin C. Because of that, loosening of teeth will be there. No regrowth will be there. Loosening of teeth and no regrowth. Regrowth of teeth will be seen in the these types of diseases. And another important thing is aching of joints. Aching in joints. Aching in joints and swelling, slow down in healing of wounds. Slow down the healing of wounds. What does this mean? If you are getting some wound, it will take time to heal. If you are getting one cut in your hand or in your leg, automatically within 1 or 2 days your wound will be recovered. But if you are having this infection, it takes time to get healed. Okay. And what is the other important thing is, it also reduces the ability to fight against the diseases. If you are having any infection, you will take time to recover. They'll term it as, it also reduce the ability to fight against the diseases. This is the one important thing. If you are getting a fever, automatically the fever will go off within 1 or 2 days, or it may take 5 days to recover. But if you are suffering from this disease, it takes more than 10 to 15 days to get rid of some fever. Think about only a fever means what about other diseases. So it is very, very dreadful disease. So if you don't have proper vitamin C in your diet, sure you will get scurvy infection. Children, up to this we'll stop and we'll close this video session with a word of prayer. The other things we'll continue in the next video session and in the next Zoom class. Before closing this video session, I would like to offer a word of prayer. Let's join together for a prayer. Our most gracious, loving Father in heaven, we thank you for this good day you have added in our life. Lord, we learnt about some diseases that is present in the childhood period. Protect us from all these types of diseases. Give them good health and strength. Lord, give us good health and strength and to stay healthy. We ask these few mercies in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, children. We'll meet in the next Zoom class and next video session. Until then, it is bye from Hemamalini, your biology teacher. Thank you. Take care. Bye.